Did your doctor order a test called ANA? Did the test came back positive? A positive ANA test is one of the most common referrals in a rheumatology office. Join me in this lecture to discuss about what is an ANA test and why was it ordered? Is the ANA titer important? Is the ANA pattern suggestive of a disease? And what are the most common causes for a positive ANA? What is the ANA test and why was it ordered? ANA stands for antinuclear antibodies. As their name suggests, they are antibodies. Antibodies are proteins produced by our immune system in response to an infection. They are part of our body defense mechanism against foreign invaders. Antinuclear antibodies are specific type of antibodies directed against the nucleus of a cell. They can appear in your bloodstream when your immune system is fired up to fight something foreign, like a virus or a bacteria or even medication. Sometimes your immune system might overreact, and that will result in directing the fight against your own body cells. In these situations, when your body cells get attacked by your own immune system, many organs will suffer. This is usually happening in autoimmune diseases. Why was this test ordered? When patients present with multiple complaints to the doctor, like severe fatigue, unexplained rashes, muscle or joint pain, low-grade fever, hair loss, or brain fog, just to name a few, and there is no other explanation for your doctor, he will order or she will order an ANA test to rule out an autoimmune disease. There are many autoimmune diseases, so this test is like an entry tool, a screening tool for an autoimmune disease, again, when there is a suspicion. However, a positive test alone without clinical symptoms does not indicate an autoimmune disease. Let's learn more. Is the ANA titer important? Many times a positive ANA screening test also comes with a titer. The titer is important. But what is the titer meaning? The titer is the level to which the patient blood samples can be still diluted and will still show positive ANA staining. That means that the higher the titer of the ANA test, the more autoantibodies are present in the blood. Can high ANA titers be seen in healthy people? The answer is yes. A positive ANA titer of 1 to 40 can be seen in up to 30% of healthy individuals. 1 to 80 can be seen in 13%. 1 to 160 can be seen in just 5%, and 1 to 320 can be seen in just about 3% of healthy individuals. I know that creates a lot of confusion among patients, but also physicians. If you think about the prevalence of autoimmune diseases is about 1%, then you can imagine that this test can be many times falsely positive. However, when these individuals carry an autoimmune disease like lupus, then a positive ANA test, even at a low titer, like 1 to 40 or 1 to 160, can be important to detect those diseases. Is the ANA pattern suggestive of a specific disease? Many times, laboratory testing for ANA will also report a pattern. The pattern refers to the distribution of staining produced by autoantibodies reacting with antigens in the cell. There are a few types of patterns reported. Homogeneous staining, when the entire nucleus is diffusely stained, or speckle staining, when there is just fine and coarse speckles seen throughout the nucleus, or centromere pattern, which refers to the presence of 30 to 60 uniform speckles distributed throughout the nucleus, or nucleolar pattern, which refers to staining just at the nucleolus. Now, is the pattern suggestive of an autoimmune disease? Actually, no. The staining pattern is very loosely associated with an autoimmune disease, but in certain situations, it might be seen more frequently. And I will give you a couple of examples. Homogeneous pattern can be seen more in patients with lupus or drug-induced lupus, while nucleolar pattern can be seen more in patients with scleroderma or an inflammatory myopathy. And speckle pattern can be seen more in patients with Sjogren. What are the most frequent causes associated with a positive NA? Now I will discuss the most common five causes for a positive NA. Autoimmune diseases. As we discussed, the positive NA can be seen in many autoimmune diseases, like connective tissue diseases, as we treat in rheumatology, such as lupus, scleroderma, inflammatory myositis, and even vasculitis, or rheumatoid arthritis. Autoimmune diseases of the thyroid, like Hashimoto thyroiditis or Graves' disease. Autoimmune hepatitis, which is another autoimmune disease of the liver, or primary biliary cirrhosis, which is again an autoimmune disease of the biliary tracts. So it is important to remember that a positive NA test does not mean that you have lupus, as lupus without a positive NA is not really lupus. Infections. Another frequent cause for a positive NA is exposure to chronic infections. When you suffer from a chronic infection like tuberculosis or histoplasmosis, your immune system is constantly activated by the virus or bacteria, and that will cause formation of autoantibodies. A few other frequent causes for positive NAs are hepatitis B or C, HIV, parvovirus B19, and even syphilis. Medications. Medications are seen as foreign substances for our bodies. As you suspect, your immune system, which is supposed to protect you from foreign invaders, at some point may see a certain medication as a foreign body, and that will cause production of autoantibodies. Medications are notorious for causing positive NA tests, and some of them can even cause difficult forms or forms of lupus. We call those drug-induced lupus. I will give you just a few examples. Blood pressure medications such as hydralazine or hydroxychlorothiazide. Other cardiac medications such as methyldopa or procainamide. Antibiotics such as minocycline or isoniazide, antifungals, but also TNF inhibitors and immunotherapy. Cancers. Rarely, a positive NA can be seen in patients with lymphoma or other solid organ cancers. If you were exposed to radiation or radiation therapy, you can also develop a positive NA. Don't forget that in the beginning of this lecture, I have told you that positive NA tests can be seen in normal people. Usually, advancing in age will expose your immune system to many challenges. from infections to medication, radiation, or even pollution that can cause a positive NA. However, keep in mind that the more symptoms you have, the higher the likelihood is to have the need to see a specialist. This video is for educational purpose only and will not substitute medical evaluation by a physician. For any medical advice, please contact your physician. In case of an emergency, please call 911. I hope this video answers many questions for you. If you like the educational content of this video, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and press the button for notifications when the next video will be released. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Rheumatologistoncall.com